Some time ago, I was watching Unity tutorials, thinking about making use of them instead of building own game engine, and it didn't convince me enough. In this video, I will ask a question: why I'm making own game engine instead of using Unity? And I will try to answer it with an example. Making a boss fight from scratch. I encourage you to watch it all and roast me in the comment section. Time is money, I respect your time. No more shit talking, let's go. TAnima is a 2D action roguelite game, just like any other similar title, but focused on the deep, freak world with a lot of exploration, secrets and storytelling. It's made in Scala, based on the libgdx framework, but it's not time to bother you with boring details. Check out my other videos if you want to know more. Things that I will be talking about now aren't just my thoughts. I've spent some time talking with other developers, some preferring Unity and some low-level frameworks. I will go through what I found out, sharing their opinion. I will try to use one argument for libgdx per one argument for Unity. So, low-level programming gives me much more control. That's somehow true. It is much easier to solve your own bugs instead of someone else. When you make something, you know how it works under the hood. You won't fight with the engine, but with yourself. I will show you a code that contains some simple bug. I will give you 10 seconds to find it out. Go! I wasted about half an hour to find it. Let me know in the comment if you solve it in time. That's where the counter argument shows up. Using engine saves the time on implementing low level things. That's also true. One of the main reasons to use Unity is because it provides a lot of great features, like the graphic editors for whatever you want. And it is flexible enough to allow you making your own plugins. Nobody wants to reinvent the wheel. On the other side, when you use a framework, there are a lot of wheels that other people made, and you can use them in your games too. Do you think that I've made this vignette, bloom or this particle effects from scratch? No, there are open source libraries that I can download and use as I wish. You can also use tech that you already know from your boring job. Of course, they are not wrapped in the fancy UI, but rather APIs, which sometimes is not enough. Do you remember my plague cook boss that I've made? I've told you that animation could be tweaked a little. And you know what? I've made my graphics object system to make cost of graphics and animations lower. There was a reason for it. I'm not an artist. Making animations by my own would be a killer. There were a few solutions for this problem. Hiring a professional artist, becoming a professional artist, or using other skills to pretend being a professional artist. I'm too poor and too lazy, so I went with the last one. This is the time when the math actually helps a lot. It was worth to learn it at school. As I'm better in programming than making the art, why would I not help myself with the code? I would do the same thing in the Unity actually, but still, it would be nice to have some tool that will speed up the process of making animation for our boss. I don't have it right now. That's obvious downside of making own game engine. Let's make this tool now. As you may already seen in my videos, from time to time I'm making some simple tool to speed up development process. This one, for example, is a simple tilemap editor created in JavaScript. It took me a few hours to finish. I could use some already existing one, but it was much faster this way. It does what I want it to do, the way that I want. Looks like shit, but works fine. In case of the animation, things are a little harder. This time I will reuse code from my engine. We will start with an empty window and console. Funny thing, I'm one of these boomers who started making games when there was nothing like game engines or indie games at all. One of my first games has been made in assembler on microcontroller connected to the alphanumeric display extracted from the old calculator. Sadly, I don't have any footage of this experiment and I didn't have a phone with the camera back then. When I was collecting data for this video, I ran into another boomer who said that frameworks are bad because it takes a lot of time and energy to make something as simple as window. I proved him wrong, as you can see. We came into conclusion that frameworks are much better for learning programming language comparing to the game engine, so if you want to learn programming, go for it. If you want to learn C# instead of Java, use Monogame. It's something like libgdx but in .NET. You know what is bad in Java? Making UI. It was always bad from the start. At least I don't need it that much in my game. Argument for Unity. Unity has a big community and has a lot of learning materials. That's true. There are a lot of tutorials. A lot. Whatever you search on YouTube, it will be there. So Monogame design patterns and anti-patterns scattered around the internet. As long as you are able to say which one is correct and which one is not, you will be okay. Vue.js community is much smaller. There are not that many resources. It is much harder to find anything. For example, I don't know how to make a drag and drop functionality to add graphics from the folder. I couldn't find a solution searching the internet. I could keep looking for it and eventually find the answer, or I could ask community on the dedicated Discord server. And it was much faster. Check out the date. Do you see anything weird here? These people should sleep right now. Yeah, me too. Argument for libgdx. Libgdx is open source and free. That's true. When it comes to the open source, some might love it and some might not. It's the same thing as with bitcoins and dollars. Some people say that it's better when there is a solid company behind the product instead of a bunch of random people from the internet. With Unity, you pay. You have. You can be almost sure that the payment model won't change in the future. Almost sure. Did you hear about Godot, by the way? It may be a good thing for you if you like the open source software. They even added support for languages other than this ugly Python-like GDScript. Eh, this C-sharp everywhere. Let's make a donation to add Java and Scala. Our tool is done. It imports and exports code, so I can still change the animation manually just like before. That's useful. I've also fixed the animation for our boss. Looks much better. Let's make a room for the boss fight. I like time maps. They are easy to use, easy now that even I can use them. What you can see here is the time map of some numbers with colors instead of graphics. There is a reason for that. I don't like tile sets. If you used tile maps before, you probably came across concept of tile sets. The simplest way to make tiles on the edges look more natural. I don't like it because it requires a lot of graphics to make. Instead, I've added conditional composition to my graphics objects. I can describe such object to look different based on the surrounding objects. It's easier for me, less graphics for sure, results is similar but the way is different. It also helps with the diversity. Lot of these objects are generated in runtime. I don't have to make multiple graphics for the same tile. I can describe how it looks like in the code, and each time it generates, it will be different. I think that you can see some kind of pattern here. Each time I came across my weakness, I use my best trait to overcome it. And as I'm a programmer, I'm making an art with the code. If I would be an artist, I would use Unity to overcome lack of my programming skills. That would be the keynote of this video for sure. That's where we are moving to another argument for Unity. Asset store. That's a great thing for someone who is bad at art. There are so many assets. It's possible that nobody used it in some other games before. To be honest, as long as developers don't make some nasty asset flips, it is a great help and development boost. But I'm one of these guys who wants to have exclusive assets. Don't judge me. When it comes to non-art assets like codes, shaders, etc., they are in libgdx too, usually on GitHub. The level design is done. Let's move to the AI. AI in TAnima is made from simple building blocks. I call them AI steps. They might look like a simple instruction, but it's much more complicated. Threads, conditions, state, events flying everywhere. I could make a full video describing this rocket science, but it's not the time for it. What you can see here is a simple AI that makes enemy change behavior according to his HP. Let's check if it works. Looks okay, you can see his HP, but it's not a problem. You will see later why. Argument for Unity. You don't need to know programming to make games. That's almost true. Did you see the blurred screen at some point and player sliding through our boss? That was a question. In TAnima there is a rage mechanic. After enough damage dealt, you can enter the rage mode, enhancing your abilities. Each of the weapons has its own ability. Also, there are minions that modifies it. Minions are something like power-ups or perks, however you call them. This one flying here are a little different. They are your HP. That's not so common way to show HP bar. Other minions may add additional rooms to the dungeon, open paths, solve quests, burn enemies and add additional attacks, etc. Each of these perks can be configured to activate on predefined actions called hooks. They can also affect other perks. Looks complicated? It is. Describing such complex logic in the graphic tools is a straight way to hell. It might be possible, but you will more likely learn programming language and write it in the code, or quit game dev and move to herding sheep business, for example, or something. Ships seems to be okay. That's why it is almost true. It depends on complexity of your game mechanics. Okay, I finished AI. Music, sound and graphic effects are placeholders for now. I will replace them with correct ones before releasing demo version. To wrap it up, I will add a scenario. If you see this yellow text, it is when TAnima, the psychopathic living crystal, is talking. She's everywhere and every time. In the plot, she's a godlike antagonist, always here for you. Writing such scripted behavior is so fast compared to drag and drop. I'm not using mouse too often. Keyboard is much faster. Okay, everything is ready. I will show you the full boss fight along with the code snippets, so you can check what is going under the hood. You can pause this video if it's too fast. I've made our boss a little easier for now to finish him faster. Everything for you. Let's go! A lot of things is going on here, as you can see. This is the first boss that you will encounter in the game. It's designed to increment difficulty level along with the fight stages and slowly teach player how the attack patterns looks like. Maybe it's wrong, maybe correct, who knows? Beta testing will be there to help making the final decision. It's time for the arguments that are the most important for me. Unity is cross-platform. That's true, it is a great feature. Godot and Monogame are similar in this case. The biggest lie about Java these days is write-ons, run everywhere. It's outdated. There is no such thing as support for Nintendo Switch in libgdx. TAnima would be great on it, in my opinion. That's why I made my own backend layer between libgdx and TAnima engine. Some time ago I've made a game for GMTK Game Jam. It was a lot of fun. I actually like the concept behind this one, and at some point I will use these mechanics to make a full game. TAnima will be there too. Name of this channel can suggest that the plot will not end on one game. That's the plan. I found out that people on Game Jam are playing more mostly web browser games. If not, they use Linux virtual machines as sandbox to not get some nasty virus. We're used to it these days, that's a correct approach. This one was distributed as Windows executable only, so there were not that many people who actually wanted to play it. It took me a day to make an abstraction layer over libgdx and swap it with pixie.js and scala.js. Right now it can be compiled to both desktop version and HTML5. Short disclaimer, libgdx works on the browser out of the box, but only if you are using Java. Scala is forbidden here. It was an important lesson. Some time ago I've made an experiment with compiling my game to the native application with GraalVM. I was one of the first developers who did this and open source working example. There was nothing that proved this concept back then. No answer in the internet. Do you even know how it feels like? Absolutely nothing. This concept somehow proves possibility of releasing Java-based games on Nintendo Switch. It's a hard work to swap libgdx backend with some more Switch-friendly one, but it's possible. I know at least one game that did it with success. We will see. I'm using libgdx because I'm a Java programmer. That's one of the most common arguments for using libgdx, the programming language. A lot of people that goes with Java are actually full-time backend web developers who don't want to change technology. Unity is based on the .NET, with C# taking the lead as the programming language. Counter-argument is that C# is simple to learn and similar to Java. That's also true. C# has been inspired by Java, just like Java has been inspired by C++. That's still not the case for me, as I'm using Scala, and sadly there is no good equivalent for it in .NET. Programmers tend to use technology that they are the most productive with. I'm 3 times more productive in Scala than I would ever be in Java, and even more comparing to C# that I still didn't learn. Unity is better for cooperation. That's true. I'm working alone right now, but if I would like to make a complex 3D game, it would be much easier to use Unity. Everyone knows Unity, as I've told you before. Maybe at some point I will use it too. Who knows? For now, I don't need it. I've separated game engine from the game content to mitigate this problem a little. The cells that I've made are easy to use, as you can see. They are becoming more human-friendly each day. I'm also adding tools to support them. I think that I've answered the question from the beginning, being as objective and reliable as I could be. What do you think? Comment section is yours.